We're delighted today to welcome everybody to NIBRT for our research conference, Medicines of the Future. In the room today, we're joined by a number of leading experts from both industry and academia. We also have a number of emerging research leaders, research scientists, and students. We're also joined by a number of esteemed speakers, including Professor Dame Sally Gilbert, Professor Elena Mazza, Dr. Larry Bacon, and Dr. Bernie Sweeney, as well as Professor Nikki Panalaskis, who will be opening the event today.
I'm so delighted to have been invited. I've learned so much about the adjacent industries outside of bioprocess, and I'm going away with lots of ideas and how we can help develop those industries within Lonza.
Conferences like these are fantastic because it allows people to engage and communicate and collaborate. By increasing awareness, it helps you recognize what other people are working on and how your work and research can align.
Conference has been really great at bringing people across different areas, from advanced cell and gene therapy to vaccines, from the really fundamental research all the way up to large-scale manufacturing. And it's great to get everybody into the room at the same time to hear what everybody else is doing, and everybody's learning together. So it's been really, really beneficial. As an academic, my interest is very on the translation side, so trying to get our findings in academia into use in patients and in the public overall. We can't bring it all the way to the public, but industry, that's what they do really well. But they can't do everything, and they have very fundamental questions that as an academic we love to be challenged by and to bring those forward as well. So that interaction between academia and industry is incredibly important. Partnership of complementary yet diverse skills and interests to answer a lot of questions that are needed to bring medicinal products to the public.
It's a great way to network and to catch up with people that we maybe haven't seen in person for a year. But importantly, it's fantastic to see the advances that have come along in terms of A, the delivery of cellular treatments, the clinical trials for cellular treatments, but also the nuances and the evolution of the biomanufacturing processes. So it's been great to bring all those things together and keep the patient's journey really at the heart of that. And we are so much more experienced now than we were 2 years ago, for example, in terms of treating patients. St. James's has now treated maybe 80 patients in terms of doing clinical trials in this area and understanding the nuances of getting really good evidence. And beginning to think about the future now that we have a number of products available to us. How do we pick and choose and roll the dice to pick which is the best product maybe for a particular indication, or at a societal level for both common diseases like myeloma and also for the rarer diseases? You know, how will we approach those things in a very nuanced way? I think what conferences like this do is they really remind you that we are in the era of personalized medicine, not waiting for it to happen. We're really in it.